With the right approach, troubleshooting a pressure tank is a lot easier than it sounds. Today, we'll be taking a look at some of the most common pressure tank pain points and how to fix them fast. First things first, make sure to power down the pump before doing any work. Open up the faucet that's part of your system and let the water run until it stops, so there's zero water pressure left in the tank. Next, you're going to find the Schrader valve. It's the little valve that looks like it belongs on a bike tire. Pop your gauge onto that valve to see what's going on inside. The cover of your system's pressure switch will tell you what the gauge should read. Whatever the cut-in pressure is, your tank pressure should ideally be exactly 2 psi below that number. So if the cut-in pressure says 40 psi, your tank needs to be sitting at 38 psi. If it's lagging behind, pump it up using a compressor. If you're noticing the pump constantly kicking on and off, that's usually a telltale sign of a waterlogged tank. When you press the Schrader valve and water decides to show up uninvited, the tank's bladder is likely done for and it's time to get a replacement. Then there's problems with the pressure switch. Sometimes dirt and debris set up camp in your well line pressure tube. It may seem like the switch is malfunctioning when it's really just clogged. Unscrew the switch from the tank T assembly and take a look inside. If it's blocked, just clean it out. The pressure tanks used in today's video are available with fast, free, nationwide shipping from Supplyhouse. Order yours today at supplyhouse.com. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel for more product tips, tutorials, and trade-related content.